Hey, I'm Thomas. Ask me anything. EV stands for electric vehicle. There are a few different types of electric vehicles. You can get battery electric vehicles, plug-in hybrid electric vehicles, hybrid electric vehicles, and hydrogen fuel cell electric vehicles. A battery electric vehicle is always driven by an electric motor, whereas a hybrid has both an electric motor and a petrol engine. The electric motor drives the car as much as possible, but when needed, the petrol engine is used to supply some more power. You can't actually charge a normal hybrid. You can, however, charge a plug-in hybrid. The latest EVs typically use a lithium-ion polymer battery. The polymer electrolyte makes the batteries lighter, safer, and have a longer lifetime. The range is getting better all the time. Some of the latest generation EVs are getting over 500 kilometers in range. Most electric vehicle owners will charge their car overnight, so they've got a full charge to start the day. There's also a growing number of publicly available rapid chargers, to the point that there's one at least every 75 kilometres along the national highway network. A lot of workplaces, supermarkets and public car parks also have free EV charging stations. This is the good news. According to EECA, if all the light vehicles in New Zealand converted to electric, the demand for electricity would only increase by 20%. And with most EV owners charging their vehicles overnight during off-peak hours, the national grid would easily be able to cope. That depends on your particular vehicle and charger. The new generation electric vehicles can take as little as 30 minutes to get a full charge. Fair point. You do have to take into account how your energy is generated. We're lucky in New Zealand. 70 to 80% of our energy is generated renewably. This means that over the lifetime of an electric vehicle, it has 60% lower carbon emissions than its petrol counterpart. Depends on how you look at it. Electric vehicles, on average, are more expensive up front. But the price is coming down and the gap is getting smaller. But consider this. Charging your electric vehicle overnight at an off-peak rate is like filling up your petrol car at 40 cents per litre. It doesn't take long for the savings to add up. No. Electric vehicles and their chargers are built to withstand the elements. Depends on how big your boat is, but yes. Certain EVs have towing capacities similar to their petrol counterparts. If you have one of the new Ioniq 5s, you can. It has an external adapter that provides 230 volts AC, the same as a standard wall socket. This means you can charge an e-bike, power some camping equipment, or plug in any household device you want. How much time do you have? Electric vehicles are structurally more simple than a petrol engine, but there's still quite a bit going on. In its most simple form, you charge up an electric vehicle battery pack externally. This battery is then used to power an electric motor that moves the car. They don't. But what does? Battery longevity, like its technology, is improving all the time. Most manufacturers offer a specific warranty on the battery as well. There are more than a dozen lithium-ion recycling plants across the world. The battery industry group in New Zealand is a collaboration between over 170 businesses. They are actively working to look at how electric vehicle batteries from electric vehicles can be reused and recycled. How does 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 5.2 seconds sound? That's what the Ioniq 5 does. It doesn't have to wait for a series of controlled explosions to get started. The electric motor provides instant torque. Along with the battery pack being low to the ground to create a low center of gravity and great handling, it's a dream. With regenerative braking, when you're driving and you put your foot on the brake, the energy that would normally be lost as heat is converted to electricity to charge your battery. About as long as a standard EV battery. Some manufacturers even include an extended battery warranty. No, Hybrids generally fall into three main categories. Full hybrids that have an electric motor and petrol engine that can work independently or together. Mild hybrids, which have an electric motor and petrol engine that always work together. And plug-in hybrids that can operate as a battery electric vehicle but also have a petrol engine to increase their range. This is a common misconception. It is misleading to call hybrids self-charging. Hybrids charge through regenerative braking. This means that they still need a petrol engine to drive. Fuel efficiency mostly, because every time you put your foot on the brake, you're generating electricity to get you moving again. And of course, the less petrol you burn, the less CO2 you're emitting. Plug-in hybrids, like the name suggests, can be plugged into the wall and charged. This means that you can drive around town as a battery EV. Then at the press of a button, you can enable the petrol engine to increase your range. It's the best of both worlds. It's pretty amazing. Once again, it depends on the charger and vehicle you have. If you're charging at home, some can take as little as a couple of hours. Yeah, that's true. The government is currently offering a rebate of up to $8,625 on new electric vehicles. Yeah, they are. Electric vehicles are exempt from road user charges until the 31st of March 2024, saving owners on average $600 a year.